Okay. I want to start with infrastructure, something that's been elusive. President Trump tried. President Biden's been trying. Can you break down the details of the bipartisan plan you're working on and why you think this has a chance to be the plan that finally gets something done?
Well, you're right. Presidents of both parties have tried to get infrastructure bills passed. President Trump actually talked about a $2 trillion bill. President Biden's is $2.65 trillion. We, I think, finally have an agreement between enough Republicans and enough Democrats to move something forward that's really common sense. It focuses on real infrastructure, meaning core infrastructure like roads and bridges, like ports in Toledo and elsewhere. And then it also does not do it by raising taxes, which would be the wrong thing to do right now as we're coming out of this COVID-19 pandemic. We want to be sure the economy stays strong. So we've got a group of 21 Democrats and Republicans moving forward. We hope that we can get some support from the White House for this approach because, frankly, it would be the largest investment in infrastructure in the history of our country by far. It also has a number of items in there that they feel strongly about to ensure that it's both good for the economy and good for the environment. So we think it's a good package, and we hope we can move it forward.
So you say largest investment in infrastructure in the history, but not raising income taxes. So how does it get paid for?
That's correct. Well, the pay-fors are a challenge, but there's three major ways. One is we take some of the COVID-19 funds that have already been appropriated here in Congress but haven't been used yet and claw some of those back. And that's appropriate because the $1.9 trillion fund that went out went for a number of things that weren't related to COVID-19. Also, there's some funding in there for the $300 supplemental federal unemployment check that comes on top of the state unemployment. Ohio has decided to give that back because so many people would be paying more, get paid more on unemployment than they would at work. That creates, we think, up to $20 billion in revenue that can be used for this purpose. And then also some of the COVID money that's already gone out is not able to be used for roads and bridges, as an example, even though states like Ohio would love to do that. So freeing that up as well creates some funding. Second, there is funding in here from an infrastructure bank where we do a long-term loan, basically, with the private sector to generate private sector funds and state and local funding, much like it's done currently with what's called the TIFIA program. So we expand that program substantially to create more opportunities for longer term investments in infrastructure, and that's really important. And then third, we have a user fee, in essence, which is for electric vehicles that don't pay any gas taxes right now, that there'd be some sort of a surcharge for those vehicles as well as hybrid vehicles so that they're paying their fair share. And the possibility also of indexing the gas tax going forward, although the White House has indicated they're opposed to that proposal. So it's a combination of different ideas, ending up with enough funding to cover, again, an historic level of funding for infrastructure that would help to move the country forward economically at a time when we need to be sure we're not raising taxes, we need to be sure we're not funding things that are unrelated to infrastructure, but really keep it to core infrastructure.
Sticking with the economy, unemployment claims rose in the country from last week. They're down slightly here in Ohio. Businesses still struggling to bring workers back. What do you think needs to be done to help stabilize the economy, get more people back to work?
Well, it's a concern because right now you've got over 9 million jobs open around the country. That's a level we've never had before. So it's a record number of job openings. And there are a lot of people who aren't coming back to work, perhaps because they're concerned about COVID. That should be less of a concern now by far because Governor DeWine's about to lift the emergency orders as an example. Yesterday I saw there were fewer than 400 new cases in Ohio. That compares to, as you know, thousands of cases over the last 18 months at times. So we really have made progress with these vaccinations. And so people should be going back to work and going back to work safely. Second, there is a concern about child care with schools being closed. Now you have the schools being open more and school years now ending. So you have kids going to summer camps, hopefully, and stuff like that because of the COVID situation getting better. So that should help. And then third is with the government at the federal level paying an additional $300 per week on top of the state unemployment, about 40 to 45% of Ohioans were getting paid more in unemployment insurance than they were at their jobs. And that was a deterrent to getting people back to work. That will end here in a couple of weeks in Ohio, and that will help as well. So my hope is that as the economy starts to pick up, we do get people back to work. It's good for them, it's good for our businesses, particularly small businesses who are struggling. A lot of restaurants are having a really tough time getting people to come back to work. And we need to have more skilled workers in Ohio too. And that's one of the challenges we're trying to deal with here, is to not just get people back to work, but to give people the skills to be able to fill the jobs that are really needed. Welding jobs, truck drivers, people who have coding skills or other information technology skills, hospital techs. Jobs like that are really tough to find people right now. So we've got some programs, including the Jobs Act, that I've proposed that we'd like to get in place to help train up individuals so that they can fill those jobs that are needed right now.
Certainly lots of investment coming to Northwest Ohio here in the near future, so lots of jobs being around. Final question, any thoughts of endorsing anyone to fill your seat in the Senate?
No, I'm not prepared to do that yet, but let me just speak, if I could, for a second. I'm excited about what's going on in Northwest Ohio in terms of investments, economic activity. I think coming out of the pandemic, more people realizing it's a good place to live and work, and the best example of that is Peloton. You know, Peloton could have gone anywhere, and instead of going to Michigan or going to some other state back east or out west, they chose Ohio. And I spoke to them about that, their decision, and encouraged them to choose Ohio. I spoke to their CEO and president about it and talked about the workforce, and they're excited, and that'll bring a lot of good paying jobs to Ohio, and it's a growth industry as well. So my hope is that we'll see more announcements like that and continue to grow our economy in Northwest Ohio.
Well, actually, just down the street from where the Peloton factory is going in, First Solar announced they're building another plant here
exactly.
in Northern Wood County, same area. So
it's really
exciting. Big things are happening here.
And First Solar,
another
example of a company that's growing, 500 new employees at that facility, and it's a growth industry. So I think that speaks well for Northwest Ohio.
All right, Senator, I appreciate your time. Thank you very much.
Thank you. Good to be on with you as always.